Today I'm in the Canary Islands, house hunting along the stunning east coast of Lanzarote.
I'm Leah Charles King, and over the years I've been involved in my family's property businesses, both in the UK and the Caribbean. Today I'm going to be using all my skills to find the perfect place for house hunters Kerry and Stuart, and we have positive signs.
Thumbs up so far?
Thumbs up so far, definitely.
Yeah?
And some negative vibrations. You don't seem to be getting the vibe
No.
here.
No, not.
Definitely not.
As we walked in, it just reminded me sort of an old-fashioned prison.
I visit a luxury villa in a celebrity hotspot.
Oh, the lifestyles of the rich and famous, eh?
Exactly, yes.
But at the end of the day, do I find my house hunters their perfect place in the sun?
Have I redeemed myself from
you
previous?
You definitely have redeemed yourself from that
you.
One.
I'm so relieved about that.
Kerry and Stuart have been married for 34 years and have enjoyed many memorable holidays together here on Lanzarote. Now all five kids have flown the nest, they feel the time is right to find their perfect bolt hole on the island. Payroll manager Kerry and accountant Stuart from Northeast England first got together when music served as the food of love.
We both lived in the same village, didn't know each other at all. I met Kerry in the local pub where I was DJing.
It was my birthday party. As it was my birthday party, I was required to make a speech and thank everybody for coming, the usual. Somebody made me feel a lot more relaxed and confident and helped me do that, yeah.
They have a budget of £120,000 to buy a holiday home on Lanzarote's east coast, where they're planning to spend long periods of time.
Now, because I'm 2.5 years away from retirement, and we want to get it in place so that when the winter months come, we can go over there and I don't have to suffer the wet and the cold and the damp.
And I'm going to retire at the same time, regardless, but I'm younger.
Lanzarote is the northernmost of the Canary Islands, and it takes about 4 hours to fly there from the UK. The main airport is on the east coast near the capital, Arrecife, so it doesn't take more than half an hour to get anywhere on this side of the island. Our search is going to be focused on Lanzarote's east coast in and around the towns of Costa Teguise and Puerto del Carmen, which are two of the most popular destinations for 3 million annual holidaymakers. They're also home to most of the 5,000-strong British population on the island, attracted by the dozens of beautiful beaches and warm, if sometimes windy, year-round climate. Not to mention all the temptations of the many bars and restaurants, which cater for tourists and locals alike. In this part of Lanzarote, two-bedroom apartments with a communal pool are priced on average at £200,000. One-bedroom apartments can be picked up for around £120,000. So this house hunt depends on how much Kerry and Stuart are willing to compromise on indoor space. Before we get going, I'm meeting up with my house hunters on the main beach in Arrecife so I can find out a bit more about them and what they're looking for in terms of property. Kerry and Stuart, welcome back to Lanzarote. How are you feeling?
Excited.
Yeah, very pleased to be here.
So what is it that you love about this place? Because it's not your first time.
No, it's not. We've been a number of times, and it's just the people, the general ambience of the place is just magic.
Yeah, I love the climate. Yeah, definitely. Winter sun is definitely the best thing, the highlight.
So why Lanzarote, particularly of all the Canaries?
For me, it's less touristy, if that makes sense. It's more laid back rather than some of the bigger islands. And that's why I want to be here.
So are you looking for a place that you could go just in the winter months?
Primarily, yes. But if it was somewhere that the family could use in the summer months, then fine.
Yeah, we're hoping to come out November, December, home for Christmas, back out for January, February, escape the damp and the cold, and yeah, we stayed home for the summer.
Very clever. You've got a good plan.
Good plan.
And in terms of what you do, I know you're retiring soon, Stuart, but what do you do back home?
I'm an accountant.
You're an accountant, and Kerry?
We work together. We have worked together for 20 years. I run the payroll side of the accountancy.
And how does that work?
It must work.
We're still together.
20 years we've worked together. 34 years we've been married, so we haven't killed each other yet.
So this is quite a harmonious union. Yeah. Which I'm loving. Do you guys agree then on everything when it comes to property?
Possibly not.
Possibly not.
We balance each other out, but whether we agree on, we don't have the same tastes.
Who's going to be the toughest customer for me to look after here?
Stuart.
Okay. Stuart's going to be... So it's Stuart that I'm really going to have to keep an eye on, and Kerry, you're a bit more laid back. Okay, so let's talk about the property itself. In your mind's eye, what's the vision?
One-bedroom apartment, two if we could do it on our budget, but that, if that's not possible, then a nicer one-bedroom. Location's probably the big thing. Yeah, it's near the beach, 20-minute walk, 30 maximum would be a good thing.
Mm-hmm. And plenty of outside space.
Pool, Stuart would like a pool.
Okay.
I'm not bothered. If I'm near enough to the beach, then I'll settle for the beach, but... He would like a pool.
As we know, two bedrooms average about £200,000. Your budget is £120,000, so that's quite a bit off.
It is, yeah.
Any way that we could twist Stuart's arm a bit?
There
get a
is
bit more
some
cash?
Wiggle room there.
Yeah?
For the ideal property, yeah, there's probably another £20,000 in the kitty.
Okay, brilliant. So we could potentially go up to £140,000. Yeah. Perfect. All right. Okay. Well, look, let's see what I can do. I've got five properties lined up, and all it takes is one, isn't it?
Just one.
One that you're going to fall in love with. So here's hoping. How are you feeling?
Excited. Ready to go.
Yeah.
Let's get going.
Yeah. Should we get going, then?
Get going.
Let's do it. I'm feeling good going into this house hunt. Although Kerry and Stuart's maximum budget of £140,000 isn't going to get them a palace out here, they seem aware of what's achievable, and I'm confident I can help them find somewhere that'll do the job. On the way to our first property, we're stopping off in the seaside town of Puerto Calero, one of the swankiest and most exclusive parts of the island. Welcome to Puerto Calero. It is actually a little playground for the rich and famous. Yes. You've got actress Penelope Cruz. She comes here on her yacht sometimes. Formula One driver Jenson Button is also known to frequent this area as well. And now you two.
Exactly.
Have you been here before?
I have, 19 years ago.
Ah.
And there was none of this here.
Really? So it wasn't built up like this at all?
Not at all.
Well, you can see there are loads more things that you could do. You could get boat rides as well. You've got some shopping. How would you feel if I told you the first property I'm taking you to see is about 10, 15 minutes drive in the car?
Excellent.
Excellent.
Fabulous.
Yeah.
Should we head that way?
Yeah.
We should.
Let's do it. Property number one is in the popular tourist town of Puerto del Carmen, where around 50% of the population is from outside Spain, including plenty of Brits. I think it will really work for Stuart and Kerry, as everything in town is within walking distance. And I found them a great apartment in a lovely development for well within their wiggle room.
Here we are. Property one. What's going through your minds right now as you look around?
Cushy.
Yeah, pretty.
Yeah, nice.
Nice pool.
Yeah.
Nice view.
So literally right by the pool, because the property I'm taking you see is this one here.
Oh, excellent.
Ain't that great?
Yeah. Can't get much nearer.
What you're looking at is a ground floor, one bed apartment. It's super modern inside. What are you thinking?
It's a nice, quiet street. Yeah, it was
positive.
Yeah.
Looks really nice. Uh-huh. Quiet.
We could see the sea in the distance.
Which is a bonus.
Yeah. There are 38 units here, and they all share this pool.
It's not a lot, is it?
It's on the market for £125,000. And there's actually room for negotiation to about 120 is a possibility.
That sounds good to
what
me.
A little dicky bird told me. So that brings you right into, you know, your budget there. How's it all sounding to you?
Sounds great at the moment.
Yeah.
Thumbs up so far? Yeah.
Thumbs up so far, definitely.
Yeah? Brilliant. Yeah. I guess you want to get inside.
Yeah, definitely.
You're like, come on, let's do it. Yeah. Let's go this way.
This apartment has a good-sized terrace leading onto the communal pool, an open-plan living, dining and kitchen space, as well as one bedroom with an ensuite shower room. Come on in. I know it's very bijou.
It is, yeah. Definitely.
I think it's quaint.
I think it's quaint, is it?
Yeah.
Definitely quaint.
It's small, but it appears to be functional.
What do you think about the bedroom sort of leading off there?
I'm a little bit concerned about that, but...
Yeah. Tell me why.
It just seems to be...
Maybe if we have people to stay and you've got to go through the bedroom room into the bathroom, that might be an issue.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Definitely.
Yeah.
If it's only the two of us, it's great. But...
But if you had guests, I understand it could be a bit inconvenient, isn't it? They'd be knocking the curtain. Can we come and use the loo?
Yeah, that's not ideal to have to walk through the bedroom.
But I know you said predominantly it would be for the two of you.
It is for the two of us, yes.
So it's not outright no, but yeah.
Yeah.
It's something to think about. It's
definitely something to think about.
But so far...
It's a good start. Yeah, definitely.
Excellent. Well, let's continue with this. And you go off into the bedroom and go and see the bathroom and everything. And I'll meet you outside when you're ready so that I could get the lowdown.
Right, no worries.
Yeah, enjoy.
Thank you.
All right. Well, Stuart and Kerry said it's a good start. And you know what? That's what we need. A good start. They haven't seen it all yet. So let's find out what they think when they've had a look around.
That's nice.
It's bright.
Bright?
Yeah.
So small, but it's...
Doesn't need any decorating or anything.
No, it doesn't. The only thing that I think concerns me is the privacy, I think.
Yeah. This...
Yeah.
...curtain. So not really, it's not really private. This big gap at the top.
I agree. I agree.
Kerry and Stuart definitely liked some things about this apartment, which is on the market for bang on £125,000, especially the outside area and the communal pool. But as they weren't so keen on the layout inside, I'm not super confident that I'm going to be starting off this house hunt with a contender. How was it?
Very nice.
Yeah?
Yeah, sounds good.
Good start.
So, what are your overall thoughts then of this property?
Well... For now, we're not ruling it out.
Okay. Right. Can we call it a contender?
Yeah, I think you can.
A tentative one, by the looks of things.
It's the privacy issue. That's the only real issue.
Right.
I think. Yeah.
So then that brings me on to moving forward then. So for the next property, what would you like to see? How can I improve on what I've just shown you?
A bedroom door.
Okay, no curtain for a bedroom door. Okay. No. All right. Let's see what I could pull out my hat for the next one. Shall we get moving?
That's a good idea.
Let's go.
Great.
So I can't complain. That's not a bad start. But I'd be kidding myself if I thought that place was perfect for Stuart and Kerry. And I'm not settling for anything less than perfection. Our next property is in Costa de Gise, the other main holiday destination on Lanzarote's east coast. So I thought we'd take in a few of the town's sights and sounds before we pay it a visit. We're in Costa de Gise, but I don't need to tell you that, do I?
No, you don't. We've been here several times.
Ah, so you know this place well?
Yes,
really well.
You stayed here?
Yeah.
Where?
Right there.
Up there?
Yeah, that room, actually.
Really? Yes. You can see it?
Yes.
It's bringing back all the memories.
It is.
Yeah, so what's it like around here in the day and in the night?
In the day, it's runners and cyclists coming along, and at night, there's bars open up and... Some nice seafood restaurants.
This sounds like a nice lifestyle.
That's the lifestyle we want to replicate.
So if I told you the next property I'm taking you to see is about a 5-minute cycle ride...
Excellent. That would be excellent.
Yeah. You'd be chuffed with that, by the sounds of things.
Certainly would.
I'd be really pleased.
Brilliant. Yeah. Shall we head off that way?
Definitely.
On your bikes, then.
Yeah.
It's that way. Coming up, I'm hoping I've hit the mark with my next property. This first floor apartment where Kerry and Stuart can be right by the pool and still enjoy plenty of privacy. Today I'm in Lanzarote helping Kerry and Stuart find their dream holiday home on the island's spectacular east coast. And so far I have a tentative contender. My house hunters, who have a budget of £120,000 with an additional £20,000 wiggle room, like the location and the outside space of this one-bedroom apartment. But they weren't big fans of its slightly unusual layout, so I found them somewhere more conventional with our next property.
It's in the seaside town of Costa Teguise, where Kerry and Stuart have had many holidays over the years. And the town certainly has everything you'd need as a tourist or a full-time resident in terms of shops, bars and restaurants, all close to its great beaches. The average price of a one-bedroom apartment here is £129,000. And I found what I think's a great one for just a little over that. So this next property is brilliant in terms of location. We are just down the promenade from where we were just hanging out in Costa Teguise. In fact, you can access all of this just from a door over there.
Brilliant. Mm-hmm. Excellent.
So I thought, first of all, we'll start off at the facilities that this complex has to offer, because you've got access to two pools. There are tennis courts here as well. So, and lots of palm trees, beach bar. It's got the whole vibe. What do you think?
Nice. Excellent. Yeah. The outside space is fabulous. Pool's beautiful. Yeah.
And of course, there's a bar next to it, which is definite bonus.
Great. So I guess you want to know which apartment.
Yeah, that would be nice.
Yeah, it's this one over there.
Oh, right. Excellent.
Yeah. So you're looking at a one-bedroom apartment. Now, I'll be straight with you, it's not as modern as the first property we saw. Does have a separate bathroom. Separate bedroom. Now, this property has been on the market for about 3 months, and it's on currently for just under £133,500. The agent had told me that it's negotiable by about 5%, so maybe you're looking about £6,000-£7,000 off from that. How's that sounding?
Sounds promising.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Shall we go up and have a look?
Certainly.
Follow me. This first floor apartment has a balcony with views over the pool towards the sea, an open plan living and kitchen area with a breakfast bar, one bedroom and a bathroom. So this is bigger and brighter.
A lot larger,
than what I showed
yes.
you earlier.
Yeah. Yes, it is. A lot bigger.
So you can see open plan living, dining, going off straight onto the terrace there, overlooking the pool. What's your first impressions as you're walking in?
It's much bigger than we saw earlier. The kitchen looks more practical for a longer stay. Mm-hmm. There's a lot more room for a pull-out bed. Yeah, it's definitely a huge improvement on what we saw earlier.
Yeah? Is it big enough, bright enough for
you? I think this is big enough.
Yeah, it's certainly big enough. I could see myself sitting at the breakfast bar while Stuart washes the dishes.
Yeah. Yeah, and it's big enough so we can actually escape from each other if we need to.
Yes. All right, now, you wanted a bedroom for a bit more privacy.
Did, yeah.
Would a door help?
A door would certainly help.
Well, let's go that way and I'll show you. How is this for a larger size bedroom?
This is definitely a lot larger than the one we saw earlier. Definitely.
Yeah, it's a big improvement.
Something you haven't mentioned yet.
View.
Mmm.
Oh, yeah.
Uh-huh. Yeah,
that's good.
All right, well, go out, look at the rest of the apartment, and I'll meet you outside afterwards.
Excellent.
They seem to like this property. There's definitely a few boxes that are being ticked here, but I guess once they've looked around, I'll find out what they really think.
There's no sinks. They're nice.
Yeah, shower curtain.
I prefer a shower. No shower curtain.
No shower curtain.
Yeah, to a bath. Yeah, it's okay. Okay, it's perfectly usable.
Yeah, it is.
Everything's in there, fridge, oven. Okay.
1970s formica.
Might have to be updated, but.
That's fine.
Not to start with.
No, that's good.
Okay, it's a nice sun trap, isn't it?
It is.
That's the most important thing, bit of winter sun.
She was fab.
She was fabulous. Yeah, I like that. Straight on the pool and across to the sea.
This apartment, on the market for just under £133,500, seems to have made a really good impression on Kerry and Stuart. And I'm not surprised, as it's a great location and has fantastic communal facilities. All of which means I'm pretty hopeful I've bagged myself another contender. Oh, hello again.
Hello.
How was it?
That was great.
Yeah?
Yeah, really liked that one.
What was it you liked?
There was more space. I could see ourselves there. The balcony was great. Yeah, I liked it.
I've got a good feeling there. Views for me. The view out the bedroom was good, and the view over the balcony. I can see the sea, but might be able to hear it. Yeah, definitely see it.
Brilliant. So, you know what I'm going to ask?
Oh, we're not ruling it out.
You're not ruling it out. Is it a contender, though?
It's definitely an improvement on earlier.
Come on, be honest. Come on.
Location-wise, it's in the running.
Yeah.
The actual complex, it's in the running.
Yeah. But moving forward, you want to see something that is a bit more modern within this budget?
Yes, please.
OK, so we'll move on to the next spot?
Yeah.
Come on, then. So I've got two contenders out of two. But to be honest, I'm not feeling great, as I appreciate neither of them are totally doing the job for Stuart and Kerry. I've definitely got more work to do. Before we visit our next property, we're taking the very short stroll to Playa Bastion, one of the many great beaches here in Costa Teguise. Have you been here before?
Yes, we have, many times.
Yeah? What is it that you like about this beach?
I like it's sheltered, it's quiet, there's no banana boats, there's no lilos, it's just peaceful.
Well, it's not far from your favourite spot in Costa Teguise. It's just a walk down the promenade, isn't it?
Yeah, it is. It's about 500 metres. It's not far at all.
So the beaches here and across the Canaries in general can tend to be a bit breezy, right?
Yeah.
So that's why this one is quite popular, because they've got these man-made little coves or windbreakers, so to speak. And in the peak time, I mean, these are usually packed with families and obviously people really making use of them. But, I mean, are you guys usually right at the edge or are you back here?
We're normally right at the edge, but if the wind does get up, we do use them. And you can still have a really good long day here, even if it's a bit windy.
Yeah.
It's sheltered.
Exactly. All right, well, we should get to our next property. It's about a 10-minute walk.
That's good.
Yeah, nice. Happy with that?
Yeah.
That'd be a nice stroll here
in
the morning, wouldn't it?
Yeah.
All right, off to you.
Thank you.
Coming up, if Kerry and Stuart want somewhere a little bit more modern and that's well under budget, then my next property could be just the ticket. Today I'm in the Canary Islands helping Kerry and Stuart find their dream holiday home in the beautiful east coast of Lanzarote. And so far I've got two properties in the running. Those two contenders are this poolside apartment and this first floor one with sea views. Though I would say that my house hunters, who have a budget of £120,000 with an additional £20,000 wiggle room, light rather than love them. And I'm hoping and planning to find them a property that really blows their socks off. Fingers crossed it could be my next place. We're staying in Costa Teguise, where we saw property number two, as I know it's a town Kerry and Stuart both really like. It's a very cosmopolitan place, with residents from all over Europe mixing in with holidaymakers and locals. Prices and demand for properties here, along with the rest of the island, have increased in the last year or so. But despite that, I've managed to find somewhere for a little bit below my house hunter's budget in an 80-apartment development right by the coast. So we're just 5 minutes away from your hotspot of Playa Bastion, and this is the outside space of the property I'm bringing you to see. This would be your entrance, but also your patio area.
Yeah.
Look, I'll be honest, you don't seem very impressed, and that's fair enough, and I just want you to be really honest with me. You know, I don't want to waste your time. I want to find you that perfect spot, so just let me have it.
The outside area space is fine.
Okay.
But the view, no. The direction of the patio, if this is the only outside area, it's not going to get the sun very much during the day.
Curb appeal isn't there. The actual block's a bit sad.
Yeah.
You don't seem to be getting the vibe
no,
here.
No, no.
Definitely not.
As we walked in, it just reminded me sort of an old-fashioned prison.
Okay, fair enough. Do you want to go inside and take a look at this property?
I don't think so.
No? You sure?
Yeah.
Okay. No, that's fine. It's a shame, but of course, this is your dream and you want the perfect place, and I want you to have the perfect place. So how can I then improve for the next one?
I think you look at the last property we saw and build on that rather than focus on the outside space. Focus on the inside space, I think.
Okay. Well, I think I've got a bit more of an idea. Just shall we get out of here then?
Yeah, please.
Yeah. You're not impressed. Hopefully I can put those smiles back on your faces.
I'm sure you will.
All right then, let's go. Wow, I won't lie. I'm a little bit shocked, but fair play to Stuart and Kerry. It wasn't for them. If they had gone inside, they'd have seen its light and bright open plan living, dining and kitchen space. One big bedroom and a recently renovated shower room. As well as all that, this apartment, which is on the market for £115,000, is in a great location close to the sea and all the attractions of Costa di Gise. But I've got to forget about it now and move on to my next place. I've got two contenders and two more properties still to see. Before we visit the next of them, we're stopping off in the island's capital, Arrecife, which is close to both of the main holiday towns we're looking in here on the East Coast. Arrecife, home to more than a third of Lanzarote's population, is a busy port city where you can get ferries to the other Canary Islands and mainland Spain. And it's also a great tourist destination, either for a day out or a slightly longer stay. So, welcome to Arrecife, which is the capital of Lanzarote. Have you been?
Never been before.
So you guys come here all the time. You've never been to the capital?
No, we haven't. That's very remiss of us.
Well, welcome. What's your first impressions then?
At the moment, it's very quiet, but I can imagine later on, when it fills up, it's going to be buzzing.
Yeah, you're completely right. Especially in the evenings, it's really buzzing. You have got bars, restaurants, lots of shopping to do as well. And right now, we're stood in the old part of town, which is actually by the saltwater lagoon.
Yeah.
Which looks different today because the tide is out. Again, when the tide's in, it looks so pretty with all the boats just sitting there. And this spot is about a 45-minute cycle ride from Costa di Gise and Puerto del Carmen, which are the areas that we've seen and I know you love.
That's doable.
Excellent.
Yeah. Good day out, isn't it?
All right, then. Look, the next property is a 20-minute drive. Shall we hop to it?
Yes, we should.
Go on, then. For property number four, we've come back to Puerto del Carmen, where we began our search. The property market here has begun to move a lot quicker recently. So if Stuart and Kerry like my next place, just 5-minute walk from the beach, and I'm hoping they will, they might have to move quickly if they want to snap it up. Here we go. The next property for you. I'm excited to show you this one, actually, because I want to show you what you can get in your budget for a two-bedroom apartment.
That sounds good.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Your eyes have lit up now.
Yeah.
Hoping to impress, okay. What's your first impression out here, this little area, the curb appeal?
I think it's nice and private and quiet, which is something we're looking for. So, yeah, I like it.
Brilliant. So, I'm taking you to see the property up there.
All right, looks okay. Nice.
Yeah. It's a nice, I think it's a bright, modern apartment. New bathroom, and of course, it's got those two bedrooms, okay? It's on for £137,500.
Okay.
So it's still within budget, just under your wiggle room, though. It's at the top end.
Yeah.
And of course, we're keeping in mind that this is for a two-bed apartment.
Yeah.
Yeah? How are you feeling at this point?
Excited about this one.
Yeah?
Yeah.
So I'm going to send you off alone on this one. Fingers crossed.
Fingers crossed.
Good luck.
Thank you.
Oh, they do seem made up about this, actually. I really want to show them what their budget can get for a two-bed, so hopefully it's got lots of potential. This apartment has a spacious balcony with a built-in barbecue, an L-shaped open-plan living, dining and kitchen area, two good-sized bedrooms and a shower room.
Yeah, this is nice.
Yeah, it's much bigger.
Yeah.
Than we've seen previously. Yeah.
Yeah. It's much bigger, much better.
Yeah. It's bright, isn't it?
It's bright.
The windows are quite large. Yeah.
The kitchen's nice. It's modern.
Separate dining area.
Yes.
Okay.
Yeah.
It's perfect.
This, I guess, is the biggest bedroom. There's a big double bed in there.
The view's not brilliant. Trees all right. Yeah. It's not the worst view I've ever seen.
No, it's not. Yeah. Hey, this is not much smaller than next door, you know.
It's almost a mirror image.
I think you're right.
Yeah, it's perfect. It's fine.
Yeah.
We have guests.
Oh, have do friends. We have to?
Yeah. We can have friends.
Yeah. But yeah, no, it's great.
Okay, it's small, but it's It's fine.
That's okay. Perfectly fine. It's got the shower we want. And I like the natural light that's coming in.
Yeah, it's a first bathroom, any natural, real natural light, isn't it?
Yeah.
Yeah.
That's okay. Perfectly adequate.
Yeah.
Okay, the terrace is big enough. The
terrace is really big enough. Nice traditional barbecue.
Yeah. Table's big enough to sit six.
Definitely.
Yeah.
Definitely.
Or my sun lounger.
And it's a sun trap.
Yeah.
It's nice, it's quiet, isn't it?
Peaceful. You wouldn't think you were just one step back from the beach.
No, you wouldn't.
Excellent.
Excellent.
This apartment, which is on the market for £137,500, really seemed to make a good impression on Stuart and Kerry from the outside. And given what's inside, particularly those two bedrooms, I'm really hopeful it's going to give me another contender.
All good?
Good.
Yeah, all good.
Come on, tell me everything. You've seen everywhere now.
It's really good.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Have I redeemed myself from the previous?
Definitely have redeemed yourself from
for
that
you.
One.
I'm so relieved about that. So what are the positives of this place?
Well, definitely positive is the two bedrooms and the amount of space.
I love the flooring. I love the tiles.
Isn't it lovely?
It's really pretty.
Yeah. So then I have to ask you, could this be in the running?
It could for me. There's one downside for you.
One downside for me is there's no pool on site, but it's in the running, definitely.
That is really good to hear. Of course, like I said, the sea is just down the road.
Yeah.
But I know what you mean. There's no communal pool on site, and, you know, but there are compromises that have to take place to get a two-bed for this price. It's pretty amazing.
Yeah, I accept that.
All right, then. Well, I have got one more roll of the dice, so tell me, how could I improve on what you've just seen?
Probably the same, but with a communal pool, if that was possible. Yeah, they're great. Two beds, size is perfect, yeah.
Well, look, I'm always positive, so let's head off and see what we could do for this fifth and final property.
Let's go.
Okay. Coming up, I hope to add another contender to the mix with this apartment, which has an absolutely stunning outlook. The views are gorge.
Yeah,
very pretty.
Today, I'm on the stunning island of Lanzarote, helping Kerry and Stuart find their dream holiday home. And I've got one more chance to really impress them. My house hunters, who have a budget of £120,000 with an additional £20,000 wiggle room, have liked three of the four properties I've shown them so far. But I don't think any of them have completely hit the mark. So I'm hoping my fifth and final place, this apartment with sea views, will be perfect in every way. But before we go there, I'm looking at the high end of the property market here on the east coast of Lanzarote. And I've come back to the chic and exclusive town of Puerto Calero, where loads of celebs like to go on holiday. I'm going to be looking around this lovely four-bedroom property consisting of two separate villas full of luxury fixtures and fittings. And I'm really grateful to agent Carla, who's making a very special effort to come and give me a tour of it. Hi, Carla.
Hi, Leah. Welcome to Villa Vista Calero.
It looks fantastic. Thank you for showing me around, especially under the circumstances.
You're very welcome. No problem.
So what am I looking at here?
So this is the main hall entrance, and the villa's actually divided into separate villas, which are identical. However, the location is a little bit different. This one's a little bit further to the back, which is Villa Salzburg, and we have Villa Vienna, which is a little bit more to the front with a beautiful terrace.
Oh, can we go and look at that one then?
Absolutely, yes.
After you. Thank you. Wow, this is a beautiful room.
Yes, it's very romantic style, the interior. The owners have brought most of the materials over from Austria, and they've kind of kept the same style throughout the villa.
Really, really nice.
Absolutely.
And although it seems quite traditional, it also seems very modern.
It is. It's been built in 2017. You have floor and ceiling heating and cooling. So it's not your usual air conditioning system, but it's actually the house cools itself down, which is absolutely amazing.
That's great.
Yeah.
Something else I could see out these windows are amazing views.
Absolutely.
Of the marina. Wow.
Amazing sea views. It's one of the best features of the house. Absolutely.
Can we get out there and take a look?
Yeah, let's go have a look.
Thank you. I know it's overcast today, but I also know this is an amazing view, isn't it?
It's spectacular. You can see the whole marina and out to the ocean. Yeah.
Oh, the lifestyles of the rich and famous, eh?
Exactly, yes.
I could also see myself sat here on this hammock, a few cocktails, watching the world go by. That would be quite nice.
It doesn't get any better than that. It's amazing.
Does it?
No.
And down there, I sneak a pool. I can see a little sneak peek.
We have a heated pool down there,
really?
And there's a big play area as well, like a games room, and a barbecue.
I'm loving this space. It's a very social space. You've got the pool bang in the middle and all the lounges around. It's really nice.
It is. You have a little shower area as well, and then we have the games room just over here.
And how much would a place like this be on the market for?
You'll be looking at $2 million, roughly.
Very nice indeed.
Thank
Carla,
you.
Thank you for showing me around.
You're
I hope
so
you heal quickly as well.
I will.
Well, that was a very special place, though I am disappointed I didn't spot any celebs strolling past. Maybe next time. Anyway, I need to swap star spotting for property finding. And to do that, I've brought Stuart and Kerry back to the town of Puerto del Carmen to check out its best and biggest beach. How is this for a beach?
It's a beautiful beach.
Yeah. So this beach is Playa de los Poquillos, which is in Puerto del Carmen, which is another area that I know, you know, we've been looking at, and you like it quite a bit, don't you?
Yeah.
The area. But what do you think of this beach? Because I know it's very different to Playa Bastion, which is your favourite beach on the island.
Yeah, this is so much bigger.
It's huge, isn't it?
It's huge, yeah.
What are you thinking, Kerry?
It's nice. Nice, gentle into the sea, nice walk into the sea, but it's huge.
And of course, you've got all the amenities on your doorstep as well, so you can make a day of it.
Yeah, definitely.
Restaurants look good, bars look good.
Yes.
Yeah, I'm sure we could use it.
So you're warming up to the beach.
We're warming to it.
I know Playa Bastion has your heart, and that's understandable because it is a beautiful little cove there. Yeah. All right, so. You might be happy to know the fifth and final property is a 5-minute walk from this beach.
Yeah, that's good.
That's quite nice.
Yeah. It is, isn't it?
Yeah. So shall we head off that way? I'll follow you. Puerto del Carmen is very popular with second homeowners from all over Europe, and there are lots of 1 and 2 bedroom apartments for sale to cater for them. I found somewhere on a great development, which I think will really work for Kerry and Stuart, for well within their wiggle room. Here we are at the buzzing pool of Property 5.
Yeah.
It's a bit of an atmosphere here today.
There is definitely a bit of atmosphere, yes.
Yeah, do you like it?
Yeah, it's nice.
See yourselves down here with a drink, hanging out with what could be your neighbours.
Yeah, could be good. Would be good.
Yeah, so the final property I'm taking you to see is up there.
Interesting.
So what's your first impressions as you're looking around this area? You're looking at the potential property.
It's a lovely complex. It's nice and bright. It's still low key. I like it.
Yeah. So what I'm bringing you to see is a top floor 1-bedroom apartment. It has views of the pool area and the sea. Okay, yeah. So hopefully you're doing a bit better there.
Yeah, okay.
It's on for £125,000.
Right.
So, smiles all round?
Yes, smiles all round.
Intrigued?
Intrigued.
Let's get up there and see, I reckon.
Let's go.
This top floor apartment has a south-facing balcony with sea views, a living, dining and kitchen area, 1 bedroom and a shower room. Come on in. So, it's... In fact, you tell me what it is. Your face is taking it all in.
It's dated.
It's quite small. Yeah, I think we would struggle with this room, but I haven't seen the rest of it yet, so there may be a bit more to it, so...
Out on terrace. The views are gorge.
Yeah,
very pretty, yeah.
Very pretty views.
Nice sea view. Yeah, yes. you can't get that everywhere.
Yeah, you can't move the view.
You could do up an apartment, can't you? But you can't fix a view out there, you know?
No, you can't.
So does it redeem the apartment at all?
Not for what we're looking for. It redeems it if I was coming here for a fortnight's holiday.
Fair enough.
Modernise the kitchen, because I'm not going to use much of it. Yeah, that's fine. It's a lovely place to come for a holiday.
Yeah.
But not for a 3-month stay.
Okay, well, go and take a look at the bedroom and the bathroom, and you never know, you might change your mind.
Okay.
Once you've done that, I'll meet you back here.
Okay.
See you in a bit. Look, I'm hoping for miracles, but if I'm really honest with you, Kerry and Stuart, they don't like this place, do they? Let me enjoy the view whilst they're waiting.
Yeah, it's...
It's okay.
It's okay, it's a bedroom.
Yeah, it's not much view.
No.
Not a main bus route.
Yeah, you can hear the bus.
You can hear the noise.
That's why they've got the extra glazing.
Yeah, that's it. Yeah, it's a bedroom.
You could do this up quite easily, but...
Yeah.
I think it's fair to say that Stuart and Kerry aren't massive fans of this apartment, which is on the market for £125,000, despite its great sea views. So I don't think I'm going to be finishing off this house hunt with another contender. Oh, here they come. Change your mind?
No.
Oh, man. You know, I was hoping that you might see potential and suddenly Stuart might want a new project as he's shortly going to retire. Nudge, nudge, wink, wink.
No, it's too much of a project.
Yeah.
And to be fair, there's no project there for me because I can't move any walls, I can't move anything around, so...
Okay. So then, that concludes our search.
Yeah.
What have we got in the running?
The one-bedroom apartment, first floor, Costa de Guise.
Mm-hmm. And the two-bedroom apartment, Puerto del Carmen.
Okay, well, I'll leave you to think about it overnight. We'll meet up tomorrow?
Yeah?
You'll tell me your decision then?
Yes.
All right, then. Let's get out of here. If you'd like more information about any of the properties featured on today's show, go to aplaceinthesun.com/programmes. We've now shown Kerry and Stuart all five properties on the east coast of Lanzarote for their budget of £120,000, with an additional £20,000 wiggle room. It's come down to a choice between this one-bedroom apartment in their favourite town of Costa de Guise and this two-bedroom property in Puerto del Carmen. Now they've had some time to talk things through, I can't wait to find out what they want to do next. Hello.
Hello again.
How are you feeling?
Tired.
Tired. How was last night? Because obviously when I left you, you'd seen five properties, all very different, and... I left you with a bit of a conundrum. So how was your night?
I took a lot of talking.
Did a lot of talking.
Yeah, a lot of discussion.
I think we eventually gave up about 2:30 this morning. Yeah.
Really?
Yeah.
That well into the night then?
Yep.
So it's a brand new day.
Yep.
What decision have you come to?
Unfortunately, no decision.
Really?
If you hadn't showed us the two bedroom, we would have probably been sitting putting an offer in for the one in Costa de Guise.
No way.
Yeah. But then the two-bedroom came along, and we just...
Yeah.
We just can't decide what to do. So we need to go back and spend some time there and try and fall in love with that location. If that doesn't happen, Costa de Guise is there waiting for us.
We didn't think we could get a two-bed. We thought it was a real big step up. Maybe it's just a little step up that we, by the time we come back, we may have... A few more funds, we might have decided it's worth that little bit extra.
Because, of course, as you know, that two-bed property in Puerto del Carmen, that was pretty much what we could find you within your budget.
Yep.
So the compromise was the location of not being Costa de Guise, which is just a little bit more pricier for a two-bed.
Yeah, and there was the other source didn't have a pool, which was what I was looking for. However, it was so close to the beach, we could have lived without that. As I say, if we hadn't seen that one, we would have been ringing the agent now in Costa de Guise and putting an offer in.
Yeah.
But wow.
Now we have...
Definitely got the right.
That was perfect, but then you come along and throw in the extra space, which we didn't think we could get. But we still love Costa de Guise, so that's the problem.
So it's thrown a spanner in the works. So really, your heart is still in Costa de Guise, and are you hoping that maybe you'll be able to raise more funds and find your perfect two-bed in that area?
Yeah.
That's the plan.
That's the plan.
I see. Well, we got there in the end.
We did, sorry. Yeah. Well, we've been so confused, it's just...
It's catching.
Yes.
Well, I wish you both all the best. I know your perfect property is just around the corner. It's got to be, right?
Yeah.
But just don't put off retirement for too long, OK, Stuart?
I won't. I'll take your advice.
Cheers to you.
Cheers.
It's been a great house search with Kerry and Stuart, and although they didn't quite find what they were looking for on this occasion, they've got a plan, and they'll be back very soon. I believe their dream home is just around the corner. I wish them both the very best. After we finished filming, Kerry and Stuart decided to make an offer of just under £121,000 on property number two, the one-bedroom apartment in Costa di Gise, which was on the market for just under £133,500. But the offer was rejected. They're going to keep hunting for a holiday home in their favourite town of Costa di Gise, and I wish them all the very best.